I just received a comment on a video I posted a few years back, but this is actually a valid question. So the video is Vectorworks Spotlight Beginner Tutorial, Add Colors to Attributes. So we have an attributes panel where we can add custom colors, and that's what that video was about. Tone Poet 1228, thanks for the question. The question is, how do we change fixture color in two dimension in Spotlight, i.e. as in color coding? This is a good question. It's actually a quite common question in Vectorworks. So here in Vectorworks, we're going to zoom in. We're going to take a look at some fixtures. We're going to change the color from that black or white default that you might see, and we're going to customize those to any other color. So here in Vectorworks, you'll see that I have some fixtures. I've already changed their color, and we'll see that we got a blue one, we got an orange one. Let's go ahead and add another fixture, and then we'll change its color as well. So I'm going to pull up the lighting device, and we're going to change that lighting device type. So it's something a little bit different. We'll scroll through, we'll get an elation, color changer on it, and we'll place some of those. The spacing's not so great, so we'll move those up here. And just haphazardly drop them for now. We can organize later. But you'll see that when I drop them in, it defaults to, in this case, it's a white line work, and that's because I have the black background turned on. So it defaults to that contrasted white. And if I had a white background, that would default to a black. But with those instruments selected, we could go to the attributes and try to change their color, their pen color. And I want to change to, let's see, this red color here. You'll notice that nothing changes. So this can be a bit frustrating, especially for beginners in Vectorworks Spotlight. So let's look at how to change the two-dimensional attributes first. So every lighting device is actually a symbol in Vectorworks composed of a two-dimensional definition and a three-dimensional definition. To find what those definitions are, let's right-click on one of the instances here on your design layer and locate symbol in resource manager. So you have to right-click on the instrument, and then you'll see this contextual click option to locate the symbol in the resource manager. Now with this symbol in our document, we can edit this one as well. So we'll edit 2D components, and I'll close my resource manager. And we'll select all of the line work. So I'll use Command A to select all the line work. And then we'll go to the attributes palette. And we'll notice that the pen color is that white or black if you're in a white background. So now we want to assign this kind of pink or reddish color. R32 is the gel color. So that assigns all the two-dimensional attribute of all the instances of that symbol to be that particular color. So we'll exit that symbol definition. And we'll notice that everywhere where we drop that instrument, it's that pink color. But if I were to go, say, look at a right side view, maybe you're looking at an elevation or a section, you'll notice that in wireframe, the line work is still white. So let's take a look at how to change that look, because you might be looking at elevations or sections with the wireframe view of this fixture. Notice that these others that I have in here are orange. So we want to make these turn out to be that pink or reddish color. So once again, we're going to select the instrument and right-click Locate Symbol in Resource Manager. Now right-click on the symbol instance in your Resource Manager and select Edit 3D Component. I will edit the 3D component of that fixture. And if you're still in wireframe, you should see something very similar to what's in your design layer. If you are in shaded, you'll see a black fixture. That's a standard. We'll change that next. But first, we want to go to wireframe. We see that we have all of our line work there. It's actually a 3D object. So we could select all those and change our attributes here once again. So Command A to select all of them, and then we're going to change to that salmon, pink, red, whatever you want to call it. Notice that the clamp is, it didn't change, and that's because it's probably defined by another symbol instance, and that's okay. We want our fixture to change color in this circumstance. So there we go. 3D definition in wireframe shows up that way, but if we look at it in shift, it still defaults to black. So how do we change the default of black? This is a group, so we're going to be able to select the texture here. Double click into the group, and if you right click on that object, you'll see Locate Overall Texture in Resource Manager. You'll see that I've created a couple of other default instrument textures. Well, the key here is to duplicate the existing instrument texture, so you probably won't have those other two there, just the black one. Let's duplicate that one, and then we're going to change the appended number here to, I'll just put pink in there. You can put the gel color number, whatever else you like to help differentiate. Now just calling it that won't change the color itself. What we have to do is edit the texture now. So with that texture selected, we right click and go to edit. So contextually go to edit. Now we're in this dialog here of shaders. You don't have to change anything here. You just have to click on the edit button there. Under the edit button, you'll see that we have a color chip drop-down list, and that goes to our attributes color selector. And we see that in our active document, we only have a handful of colors, and one of those being that salmon paint color that we're looking for. We say okay, and that changes the preview here. And then we'll select okay. And we'll notice that nothing changed in our 3D definition. What we have to do is actually apply that texture to that fixture, because right now that fixture is still looking at the default if instrument texture in Vectorworks. So we'll drag and drop this texture for this circumstance here, exit that group, and we see that we could change the yolk color as well if we want to. Yolk. Okay. I'm not going to change the clamp. We'll leave it the same. When I exit that definition of the 3D, and then we'll go to a shaded view. We've got some lights on, and I've placed all those textures in the same level of my ground plane. I didn't do a different design layer, but you see now that all of the fixtures have their own respective custom colors applied, as well as custom texture color. So we're a little bit beyond what you asked, but I hope this is really helpful, because now you have the ability to color code not just your 2D plans, but also elevations, sections, rendered views, in shaded view. This particular texture is going to be custom for you, color coded, nice and custom. So great question. Keep them coming. If you got any other questions, please comment down below on this video or any of our other videos here on YouTube. Thanks so much for tuning in. If you like this, you know what to do. Yeah, the like button down there helps us out a lot. Just lets other people know that we've got some good content here on this channel. And if you'd love to see us again, please subscribe. You know, if anybody that could use this, please share the channel with your friend. So thanks so much. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you real soon.